City. Hallo allemaal, welkom bij Sap City, het muzikale lifestyle magazine. Zoals je ziet, we komen deze week vanuit Londen. We gaan deze week dan ook kijken naar alle ins en outs over hype en hip in Londen. Verder gaan we op bezoek bij DJ-producer Mr. C. En we gaan kijken naar visuals. Wie zijn nou de makers achter de beelden? We hebben bovendien ook nog aandacht voor Studio 54, de grote première party in Amsterdam Studios. Maar nu eerst...
In the house, at this time. See what's up to the laws of funk, as we proceed to do it like this. Ladies and gentlemen, you'll make some noise one more time for the hard four, please.
Londen is tevens de thuisbasis van Mr. C, een van de top DJ's van Engeland. We gaan nu even bij hem langs. Londen is niet alleen een hippe en trendy stad, maar bovendien ook nog eens de thuisbasis van DJ-producer Mr. C. Laat ik nou toevallig naast hem zitten en even met hem gaan praten over een aantal dingen. Hi Mr. C.
Hi.
I was going to say welcome, but then again we're in your town.
Yes, welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome to our town.
Yeah, London is your musical home base, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let's talk about your music. I mean, you've been in the music industry for over 10 years now.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is that you have been there as, from all the size you can be in the music industry, as a DJ.
As a producer, as a band, as a record label, as a studio, as a club now, with my partner Leo, yeah, so. There's all parts of the music industry I find interesting. There's not any one specific part I would say that was more relevant than another. You know, whether I'm DJing or whether I'm in the studio or whether I'm working with my pals, you know, it's all the same thing. It's all like pushing towards the same goal. So it all kind of comes under one big umbrella.
Do you think that there's still too much distance between the different gates of where the music is being played? I mean,
well, it seems to be interacting a lot more, you know, like producers and record label people are all hanging out with DJs or hanging out with promoters. So it all seems to be merging into a sort of like almost like one big happy family as such, whereas a good few years ago, the producers didn't really hang out in the club so much. Not many DJs were producers, you know, it didn't really mix and match so much. But nowadays, I think it's, you know, people realize that we've all got to work with each other, whether it's like promotions, producers, DJing, radio, everyone needs everybody else to help them with their products.
Can you remember a moment when you felt really, really valued? Because like you said before, when you started out in music industry, you weren't doing all these things that you're doing now.
Yeah.
So when was the time when you said, yes, people are finally beginning to understand what I'm trying to do?
I think the first time I got that feeling was probably in 1989. Yeah, I was basically just DJing and I was playing in a very, very commercial club. And after playing only for 30 minutes, the promoter asked me to come off the decks. Yeah, he didn't like what I was doing. And I was like, what do you mean you don't like what I'm doing? This is ridiculous, you know, after like asking me to play here. And he said, well, none of my friends know the records you're playing and they can't tell where the joins are. Yeah. So I'm like, hold on a minute, this is ridiculous. What, am I in the wrong industry here? They really don't understand, yeah? And at that point, I was going to give up DJing. And when I sort of alerted my friends that I was going to give it up, they went mad. They was like, no way, you can't give it up. Who are we going to listen to? Do we have to go and listen to this commercial mainstream rubbish? And at that point, I felt valued.
Let me see y'all rocking the house, co-rocking the house, co-rocking the house, right? Don't stop. Don't stop the body rock. Yes, we got just about time.
One other thing I was wondering is, does the place where you come from, London, inspire you?
Absolutely. London inspires me every day. You know, just like the atmosphere, the attitude here. It's very fast, it's very energetic. The way that the people are is a total inspiration. I couldn't do what I do living anywhere else. Mm. No way.
Londen is niet alleen een hele trendy stad, maar ook een hele interactieve stad. Dus heb je hier in deze stad verschillende hotels waar je tot aan je kamer aan toe bijvoorbeeld kunt beschikken over ISDN en alle andere mogelijke technische vernuften. We gaan eens even kijken wat er vandaag allemaal te beleven is in Londen. En we zoeken daarvoor een site op die ons dat helemaal kan gaan vertellen. Kijk, Portobello Road. En hier is het dan, Portobello Road Market. Een van de bekendste markten van Londen en ook een van de leukste waar je van alles en nog wat kunt vinden. Het is er altijd druk en ze verkopen een uiteenlopend genre van dingen. Tweedehands kleding, leuke tasjes, schoenen, hebben dingetjes. Dan opeens midden op de markt een van de hipste bars van Londen. De Beat Cafe. Nou, en waarom is dat hier nou zo hip? Ik zal je precies vertellen waarom. Ze draaien hier de hipste muziek. Er zitten hier de meest trendy mensen. En het leuke van dit alles is dat het allemaal plaatsvindt gewoon 's middags. Gewoon overdag. Want Londen staat natuurlijk bekend als trendsetter op uitgaansgebied. En dus moest er iets nieuws gevonden worden na het urenlang stappen midden in de nacht. Nou, je kunt hier dus gewoon de hele dag door binnenkomen. En ja, op de een of andere manier is dit waar het gebeurt. Iedereen zit hier lekker relaxed, lange huid achterover. Je kunt hier je huiswerk maken. Je kunt hier gewoon even chillen met vrienden. Je kunt hier de meest interessante, heftige discussies voeren. Je kunt hier gewoon eten halen wat je hiernaast kunt krijgen in een zeer bijzonder vegetarisch winkeltje waar ze alleen maar de meest gezonde producten serveren. En mag je hier dan gewoon in de Beat Café opeten. En dat allemaal midden op Portobello Road Market. Dat is nou Londen. Naast mij zit The Ant Sound System. Hi guys.
Hi.
You are The Ant Sound System. Now, a sound system to me is like a portable radio.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can take places and just press a button and music comes out. Well, you definitely are not portable, not for me anyway. So why don't you just quickly introduce yourselves and tell us all about the collective that you are.
I'm Matthew Bushwacker B. This is Leo and Mr. C, who we met.
Yeah.
Collectively known as the N Sound System. Three DJs playing on four decks, continually switching around, taking in turns.
Actually playing together?
Yeah, on four decks.
We're the N Sound System.
And we'll see you at Zap City.
Zap City.
Okay. Missed that. Can't wait. <Sorry. laughs>
One of the things I like very, very, very much about nightlife in London is the diversity.
Yeah.
There's a club for everybody.
There's a club for
every night. I mean, well, I'm from Amsterdam, and you know, even though Amsterdam is this great big city, you can't go clubbing every night.
Yeah, and there's not so many clubs in Amsterdam.
It's ridiculous.
There's hundreds in London. Hundreds.
And there's a club for no matter what you like, you'll find it
somewhere.
You'll
find it here.
Do you have regular nights when you say, oh, when I want to hear this or that, I'll go there, or favourite clubs that you frequent?
I mean, that's the beauty about owning The End is that we've been able to pull in lots of different genres here.
Yeah.
You know, we do all sorts from hip-hop, drum and bass, house, techno, electro, big beat. You know, we cover quite a lot of things.
Well, we're here in London to find out all about the hotspots, so we're definitely going to check out some.
Good, you have to check out all the bars and all the stuff, so you have a good time.
Some
really nice stuff to check out.
Yeah?
Yeah, hit Soho. Soho would be a good laugh.
Precies tussen Oxford Street, Regent Street en Piccadilly Circus bevindt zich Soho, een van de uitgaansgebieden van Londen. Veel verschillende restaurants waar je kunt eten van sushi tot en met Spaans, Italiaans en het allemaal authentiek. Ook veel leuke winkeltjes, galeries en natuurlijk de stiekem sexshops.
Legacy it leaves behind is phenomenal.
Forget it, they were going nuts to it.
All the big movie stars and the big actors.
Star fucking.
No way.
Yeah, sure.
Throughout all cultures, whether it be Celtic cultures, shamanic cultures, tribal African cultures, it really doesn't make any difference. We will always need to dance to the drum.
Hectic Illusions is een crossover mediabedrijf wat zich bezighoudt met alle mediatypes van print tot en met video tot en met interactieve producties. Voornamelijk eigenlijk gericht op de dance scene. Dat is ook de oorsprong van het bedrijf. Dus dat we vanuit de dance scene binnen het grafisch ontwerp van platenhoezen, flyers, het VJ'en in clubs naar de commerciële reclamewereld zijn verplaatst. En daar eigenlijk ons eigen ding integreren in een groter geheel. De kracht van alles wat we maken is dat we oude traditionele mediatypes combineren met nieuwe media. Waardoor we niet alles vanuit de computer willen doen. Ik denk dat er een hele generatie mensen is die denken dat als je een computer hebt dat je alles kan maken. Je koopt een CD-ROM, je kan clips en platen maken met één druk op je muis. Wij gaan ook gewoon terug naar ouderwetse papiertjes knippen en plakken, letters uitsnijden. We gooien wat verf tegen een muur en het kan ook een basisingrediënt zijn voor bijvoorbeeld een videoclip. Inspiratie komt vooral voort uit het dagelijks leven. Op het moment dat je 24 uur per dag in de studio zit, 5 dagen per week, heb je niet genoeg input om frisse dingen te kunnen blijven maken. Ik denk als je binnen 4 muren zit, dat je heel snel beperkt wordt tot alles wat je om je heen ziet. En dat komt ook terug in je werk. Op het moment dat je over een markt loopt en je ziet vissen liggen, je loopt in een supermarkt, je gaat op vakantie, je duikt, je bent onder water. Alles van het dagelijks leven is eigenlijk een inspiratiebron. Wat we eigenlijk willen met het VJ'en is mensen een vrolijk gevoel geven. Ze moeten niet in een chaotische wereld zitten, maar ze moeten kunnen genieten van de pure muziek en puur beeld. En gewoon in een lekkere positieve omgeving lekker los van de beer kunnen gaan. eigenlijk een soort film om op te dansen zonder verhaal.
This is based around Studio 54. It's based around the premiere of the movie here in Holland. We'd like to know everything about Studio 54. So basically, could you tell me something about the period in which the whole club started?
We're talking 1977. You're talking the height of, I guess what you could call the pleasure decades.
Yeah.
You're talking about before AIDS. You're talking about exactly the time when disco became like the biggest thing since sliced bread in America.
Do you have the feeling that people in that period felt like, this is going to be called a legend, you know, 20 years later.
You know, I didn't speak to many of them about that particular topic. I think that everybody was very conscious that it was a very, very special party. There was nothing ever like that before. It was just like so out of context with whatever else was going on at the time. It was so advanced in terms of like a party. I think that people were really understanding that this was the only thing like this there had ever been. The scene at Studio 54 was a lot more about a party that had all these different elements that were mixed in a very thoughtful way.
Was that coincidence, or did they really think about it?
Oh no, that was, I think that really happened little by little, but it did bring in a lot of people who had a very special talent for making a party incredible. There was this guy who was probably, I think he was working on Wall Street during the day, and at night he dressed as a woman on roller skates, and it was called Roll Arena. And he would be there every night with these amazing old lady outfits and those American 50s glasses and, you know, on roller skates, dancing. And then there was Disco Sally, there was like this grandmother that was like 75 or 78 years old. It was so small and, you know, she actually got married, I think, there.
Could you tell us something about the artifacts in Studio 54? For instance, the Man in the Moon?
Well, it was just a reconverted Broadway theater that had a pretty big stage area. The dance floor is in the front of the stage, but then behind all that there was considerably more space behind the curtains where they were able to have all the theatrical backdrops going up and down, and so they kept changing the scenery, just like in the theater would.
Yeah.
And the man, the moon, was just one of the backdrops they had. They had an incredible amount of them. They had these little lights that were going from the spoon to the. So when it activated, you saw the lights go.
What did that mean?
Well. I think that I don't need to really tell you what it means.
These, can you hear me, Amsterdam? My name is, ladies and gentlemen, up in the house, and I came to celebrate Studio 54.
Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Owens. Truly one of the pioneers of house music. You remember Breaking Down the Walls, Can You Feel It? That was the lead vocalist in Figure Skating. Truly one of the pioneers of house music.
How does a musician become a DJ? Usually it's the other way around.
Well, I hate to sound very pragmatic, but you should try to carry a whole set of drums on one side and carry a box of records on the other side. See which one you like better.
Can you remember like your first DJ set, like the first one you were really going like, okay, this is it, I want to be a DJ?
Well, I mean, I had done DJing before that in France, but it was the opposite. I would play records in this big bar, very big, but if people started dancing, the owner would curse me out because he said that when they dance, they don't drink as much. So the aim of that part was to make people not dance.
Oh,
I think the point of DJing is to entertain people and to make them feel something and to take them on some kind of a whatever little journey you can and give them a message. Well, the point is the story you're telling with the songs. The point is the message that you're subliminally getting across to your listeners. Are you trying to give a message of love and peace? Are you trying to give a message of destruction and hate? Are you trying to give a message of, you know, questions or uncertainties? Are you trying to reassure your... that's really up to your individual style as a DJ, whether you're even conscious that you should give people a message through the songs.
So what are you going to play tonight?
I don't know yet. If I knew what I was going to play, I would have just sent you a tape.
Mm-hmm. Well, what kind of records did you bring? What do you carry around?
I don't know. I think I play a bunch of obscure and well-known things in whatever order, really. It's not what counts. What's important is what am I going to do with them, and I don't think we can talk about it until you see me do it tonight.
Okay, we're going to check you out tonight.
Yeah.
All right, thank you very much.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
Je kijkt naar Zep City, het muzikale lifestyle magazine. Ik hoop dat je ervan genoten hebt en tot gauw.